Ya, assalamualaikum dan juga salam sejahtera. Okey, hari ini kita akan sambung chapter 2. Okey. Dan hari ini kita bercakap tentang Laplace transform. Okey. Mungkin this a little bit revision apa yang kamu telah belajari dalam mathematics. Okey, sebelum kita gunakannya nanti. Okay, the ability to obtain linear approximation of physical system allow the analyst to consider the use of Laplace transform. Okay, rasanya semalam kamu telah pelajari macam mana nak dapatkan linear approximation. Okay, once kita dah boleh buat yang itu, okay, kita perlu cari penyelesaian. Salah satunya kita boleh gunakan Laplace transform untuk dapatkan penyelesaian. Okay, the Laplace transform method substitute relatively easy solved algebraic equation for more difficult differential equation. Okay, cuma semalam dalam example yang spring tu kita tak ada differential dalam equation tu tak ada differential punya term. Okay, jadi sebab tu kita boleh selesaikan dengan mudah. Okey. Tapi biasanya bila kita dapatkan the linear equation, biasanya selalunya terdapatnya differential term. Dan bila ada differential term, okey, selalu kita tak boleh selesaikan directly gunakan algebra seperti semalam. Okey. Tetapi kalau kita boleh substitute gunakan Laplace transform, yang mana later on kita juga boleh selesaikan that equation dengan menggunakan algebra. The time response solution is obtained by following operation like this. This is the step. Okay. First, we need to obtain the linearized differential equation. Okay. And then afterward, we need to obtain the Laplace transform of the differential equation. Okay, kita kena transformkan ke dalam Laplace. And then, after that, barulah kita boleh solve the algebraic equation for the transform of the variable of interest. Okay. Sebab maksudnya bila kita dah lakukan Laplace transform ni dekat step yang kedua, kita tak perlu gunakan integration lagi untuk menyelesaikan equation tersebut. Okey. Jadi basically the Laplace transform dia akan mengelakkan kita daripada melakukan integration, pengkamiran. Apabila kita nak selesaikan nak dapatkan solution kepada equation tersebut. Okay, Laplace transform for linear differential equation. The Laplace transform exists for linear differential equation, okay, for which the transformation integral converge. Okay. Therefore, for FT, which means the equation which has the function of time, to be transformable, it is sufficient that it fulfills this criteria, which if this FT, the function, okay, we multiply with the exponential of minus sigma 1 multiplied by t, okay, and then we take the integral between 0 to infinity, okay, and the hasil tu kita akan dapati dia adalah less than infinite. Maksudnya the result is a finite number. Okay, so if it is fulfilling this criteria, basically the equation is transformable. Okay? The only thing here, when we take the integral, we always take from zero negative. We mean that because sometime when the time equal to zero, okay, because sometime there is a discontinuity happen there, okay. So to avoid the problem of that we are not detecting the discontinuity, so we need to check the integration, okay, from zero negative, okay. It means that before zero, okay, just before zero. The zero negative indicate that the integral should include any discontinuity, such as delta function at time t equal to zero. If the magnitude of the Ft is less than m multiplied by exponential of alpha t for all positive t, the integral will converge for all ni simbol apa tadi? Allah lupa. Sigma. Okay, sigma 1 which is greater than alpha. Okay. So the region of convergence is therefore given by infinity, which is the sigma 1 should be smaller than infinity and should be greater than alpha. Okay, and sigma 1 is known as abscisa of absolute convergence. Okay, so this is basically the definition of the Laplace transform. Okay, if you refresh back your mathematics, okay. Okay, Laplace transform also can be inverse. Okay, signals that are physically realizable always have a Laplace transform. Okay. And the Laplace transformation of a function of time Ft is like this. Okay? If you have an equation, okay, which is written as a function of t, okay, to get the Laplace transform, okay, when we do the Laplace transform, basically we are converting the domain from time domain, from the T to S domain. Okay? And to get this Fs from this Ft, basically we need to multiply with exponential of minus St. And then we take the integration, okay, between in 0 minus until infinity. Okay, so this is basically the process of Laplace transform where the integration is being done. Okay, and we can write the Laplace transform also in the form of symbol L. Okay, so L means the Laplace, okay, Laplace transform of function Ft. And the inverse Laplace transform, okay, can be written like this, because if we have the function in the S domain, okay, we can multiply with the exponential of positive S as T, okay, and then take the integration from sigma minus j infinity until sigma plus j infinity, and then we multiply it by 1 over 2 pi multiply by j. Okay. With this equation, we can convert back the S domain to T domain. Okay. So basically, when we are talking about Laplace transform, basically we are transforming the equation from T domain to S domain. And when we talk about inverse Laplace transform, we are converting the equation from S domain to T domain back. Okay? So this is in terms of mathematics. Okay? Basically, the Laplace transform basically involving the integration. Even the inverse Laplace transform also will involve the integration as well. Okay? The transformation integrals have been employed to derive table of Laplace transform that are used for the great majority of problem. Okay? Luckily, that the transformation integral that is being employed in the Laplace transform has been written in the form of tables. Okay? So that later on you can refer to the tables only. You don't need to do the integration. Okay? Okay? Because actually if you need to do this integration to get that Laplace transform, okay? So it's quite difficult, okay? But the Laplace transform has been done for some of the general equation, okay? And it is written in the table, and later on when we want to use, we just refer to the tables only, okay? So this is the table of Laplace transform pair. Okay. So this is on the left side is basically the equation written in the time domain. Okay. The FT. And the FS is the Laplace transform of the equation written in S domain. Okay? For example, if you have the equation written in time domain, okay, and if you want to transform it to S domain, so you just check your equation is equivalent to which equation, similar to which equation. Okay? Let's say it is similar to this cosine. So basically the its transformation in the S domain will become like this. Okay? And if you have the equation in the S domain, let's say you have the equation like this, okay? So the transformation in T domain will become like this. Okay? The first few of this is basically we normally use. Okay. One of them is the step function. Okay, step function in the time domain we normally write as u as a function of t. Okay, step function when we transform it into S domain, it will become 1 over S. Okay. This is after implementing the integration equation before. Okay. We will get that one. Okay, if you want to prove it, you can try it yourself, okay, with that equation. Okay, and if we have the equation in the form of exponential, exponential of minus at, okay, when you transform it, it will become 1 over s plus a. Okay, normally a is the constant. Okay, so we just need to substitute the A with the value that we have in this equation. Okay, if we have the sine, okay, equation, the sine equation, basically when we do the transformation to the S domain, okay, sine omega t will become omega divided by S square plus omega square. Okay? And for the cos omega t, okay, it will become S over S square plus omega square. Okay? And then if we have an equation written as t to the power of n, okay, n can be any number lah, 1, 2, 3, or whatever number. Okay? So it will become factorial of n divided by s to the power of n plus 1. Okay? And this one, if we have the differential equation, okay, if we have the differential equation, normally we write as a f either prime or double prime or triple prime and so on, which in the place of k as a function of t, or maybe we write it as d to the power of k ft over dt to the power of k. Okay, k can be 1, 2, 3, and so on. Okay, for this case, okay, the the Laplace transform of it will equal become s to the power of k, because this is the power of is k, multiplied by fs, okay, and then minus s to the power of k minus 1. You see, we're decreasing. Now s to the power of k will become s to the power of k minus 1 multiplied by f at the time of t negative 0, 0 negative. Okay? This means that at the time of t equal to 0. Okay? And then minus s to the power of k minus 2. You can see that the power of s is decreasing. With minus 1, minus 2. And then we go on, become minus 3 and so on. Okay? Until we'll become s to the power of minus 0. Okay? Here is actually s will become s to the power of 0. That's why it become 1. Okay? S to the power of 0 is equal to 1. That's why it's not appear here. And then for this one, okay, we multiply. You can see that here we don't, here is just fs. Here is just f0. And this one is f prime 0, increasing, you know. And then afterward, if we have more, it should be f double prime 0. And if we have more, it become f triple prime 0. And then here, we'll have f to the k minus 1, 0. Okay? So we end here when an s to the power of 0. Okay, later on we will do exercise on this. Okay? Maybe we will practice on how to do this. This one may be a little bit difficult to get the conversion. And then next, if we have integration, okay, if we have integration like this, ft, and then we integrate between negative infinity to t, so the equation will become like this. Okay, fs divided by s plus 1 over s, and then there, this is integration of negative infinity to 0 for ft dt. Okay, and that is for integration. And then if we have impulse function normally we write as delta t. And then it will, when we convert it to S domain, it will become 1 only. Okay. And then I think the one most important is the from the top until here. Okay. If you notice this one and the rest is basically the combination of the above. Okay. This one is combination of exponential and also sine. This one is exponential and the cos. Okay. So either you can, if you have the, like this, either you can break them into individuals and you solve one by one by using the above here, or you can utilize this directly to convert directly. Okay. Okay, and then we have more equation for complex equation. Okay, this one also is more into combination. Okay, it's combining some of these. Okay, maybe you can combine some of the equation before, and basically you will get this one. Okay, basically you can simplify also this one to that simple equation. Okay. But if you find this equation, the equation is similar to any of these equation, complex like this, if you don't want to break them into small pieces, okay, you can directly use this equation and then get the conversion here. Okay? So this is the Laplace transform pair. Okay, that we will always use, because when we use this, we don't need to do the integration, okay, as appear in the mathematics. Okay, I think the most important thing when we working with the Laplace transform is the differential and also integral operator. Okay. Because in Laplace transform, okay, the Laplace variable S can be considered to be differential operator, so that it'll become like this. Okay, it is actually when we have the S variable in the S domain, in time domain it is equivalent to the derivation d over dt. Okay, so when you are transforming, actually whenever you see the d over dt, you can replace with S. Okay, in order to transform to S domain. Okay, that's why later on, that if your equation have derivative terms, it will be replaced by S, and because of that, the derivation term will disappear. And that's why later on when we trying to solving that equation, okay, when you're trying to solve the equation already simplified because the derivation term will disappear. Okay, same also with the integral operator. Okay, when we have the integration operator terms in the equation, okay, In the S domain, basically, it is equivalent to 1 over S. Okay? So, when in the equation, we have the integral term like that, we replace it with 1 over S, which means that the integral term will also disappear. And basically, we can solve the equation using algebraically only. Okay, the inverse Laplace transformation is usually obtained by using the Heaviside partial fraction expansion. Okay. As I said before, when we do the inverse Laplace transform, the equation that we have may be complex. So what we can do, we can break them into small fraction. Okay. Using the partial fraction expansion, and then the equation becomes simple, and then we can use the simple equation to do the transformation. Okay? But if you don't do that, you can use the complex equation also to transform it, doesn't matter. Okay, this approach is particularly useful for system analysis and design because the effect of each characteristic root or eigenvalue can be clearly observed. Okay? The only thing when we do the partial fraction expansion, because we split the equation into small part, okay, later on we can see we can clearly observe the effect of certain effects, okay, from that equation. Okay, maybe tomorrow we will have some example that we can. Awal lagi ya? Kalau kita nak start dengan the next punya slide. Kita start sikit lah. Supaya hari Senin kita boleh ni. Kita sambung sikit lah sampai 11.45 ke. Okey. Tadi kita mempelajari tentang Laplace transforms. Okey. Here is where we going to use the Laplace transform to solve some of the differential equation. Okey, kita back kepada kita punya simple system, spring mass and damper system. To illustrate the usefulness of Laplace transform and the step involved in the system analysis, reconsider the spring mass damper system described by the equation like this. Okay? Last time, okay, we already derived the equation, okay, from the Newton's second law for the mass spring damper, where we said that this is the force acting, okay? This is the force because of the spring, okay? And then this is the force because of what? Because of the friction or damping, okay? And this is the force because of the mass, okay? Okay, I said it before as well, that this equation is written as, because the output is the displacement y as a function of t. And the input is the force, which is the rt. Right? Okay, this is the input. But the equation is written in the form of input equal to something multiplied by output. Right? Okay? But when we try to get the solution for this equation, we want to reverse the equation so that it will become the output should be equal to something multiplied by the input. Okay? So because there is a differential term here, this is second order, this is first order, okay? And because of that, we cannot solve this equation algebraically. Right? Okay? Kita tak boleh just move around the y untuk supaya dia jadi di depan. Okay? So we wish to obtain the response y as a function of time. Okay? So for that case, we can utilize the Laplace transform. Okay? If we refer to the Laplace transform pair tables, we have the transformation of the function in the time domain to the function in the S domain. Okay? In this case, because we have the differential like this, we can refer to the table which in the row of this one. We have the differential equation like this, right? And if we refer to the table, the S domain function for that equation will become like this, right? Okay? Okay. So with this, we can do one by one, okay? Okay, first of all, for this one, okay, to do the Laplace transform of this one, okay, if we refer this one to these tables, okay, what we can see is that the k should be equal to 2. Is it right? Okay, the k should be equal to 2. That's why we replace this with 2, s to the power of 2. That's why we get this one. And then the only thing, this one instead of ft like this, it is yt. Okay, so we just change here the f become y. Okay, so we have ys there. Okay, and then here k just now is 2. 2 minus 1 is become 1. So we have s to the power of 1. Okay? And then we have here f0. Here should be y0. Okay? Because we have yt here. And then after that, okay, we have k is 2 minus 2, okay? 2 minus 2 become 0, right? So here become s to the power of 0. Okay, s to the power of 0 is equal to what? Is equal to 1. That's why we don't write the s here. Okay? And then we have the f prime here should become y prime. Okay, y prime 0 is basically is equal to dy0 over dt. Is it right? Or you can write as a y prime 0, no problem. Okay? So, we finish with this. Okay? And then next we go for this one. B multiplied by something. This one, the whole thing we need to multiply with m, because for this, okay? But for this, this one should be multiplied with b. And if you look at this, compare with this, what is the value of the k? Okay, the value of k is 1. So it started with s to the power of 1 multiplied by fs become ys. So s multiplied by ys. Okay? And then here, k is basically 1 minus 1 becomes 0. So it'll become 1, right? S to the power of 0. So we don't write the s there. Okay? And then this one is f0 will become y0. Okay? So whenever the power of s becomes 0, we terminate there. Like here before also, when s to the power of 0, we stop there. So here also same. We stop there. Okay? And then for this one, okay, this one, because we have only y as a function of t, so we just convert it to become capital Y as a function of s. Okay? The only thing, don't confuse, to make us, the equation that is written for s domain is normally in the form of capital. In Y domain, normally we write in the form of small letter. Okay? That's why the Y here should be written as capital Y. Okay? And similarly here also, the RT, when we transform it into S domain, it will become RS. Okay, boleh ikut lah. Ada soalan tak up to ni? Semua adalah based on the equation yang ada dekat table ni. Okay, once kita dah transform, okay, once we have transformed that equation, kita dapat tadi equation tadi macam ini. Okay, next what we need to do, okay, kalau dekat equation ini you notice, you ada y0, y prime 0, ataupun dy0 dt, di sini juga y0, okay. Zero ni mean adalah, yang zero ni maksudnya adalah the time is equal to zero. Time equal to zero mean the initial condition. Okay. Jadi, let's say kalau katakan kita boleh tahu ataupun kita diberi bahawa the initial condition of the system. Let's say, kita diberi yang mana the initial condition y0 is equal to satu constant. Mungkin kita just written as y0. Dan dy over dt yang ini tadi is at time 0 is equal to 0. Ini pun basically is same as constant, cuma the constant value is 0. Okay. Let's say kita tahu this one. And then the other thing mungkin kita ada diberikan bahawa let's say kita tak applying the force to the system. Jadi bila kita tak applying the force, the RT sama dengan kosong. The input ni. Okay. So if you know that, basically we just replace. Because RT equal to kosong, so RS basically will equal to kosong. Okay. And then y0 kita replace dengan yo. Okay. Dy0 over dt is equal to 0. Kita just replace there. And then ini pun sama. Kita kena replace dengan yo. Okay. The y0. Okay. Dan once kita dah buat yang tu, kita boleh selesaikan equation ini. Okey. Kalau kita rewrite balik kita punya equation, mungkin ini kita kalikan dengan yang dalam ni, kita akan ada m s square multiply by ys minus m multiply by s multiply by y0 plus b multiply by s multiply by ys minus b multiply by y0 plus kys sama dengan kosong. Okey, kalau you perhatikan equation ini, sekarang ni ada lagi tak ada differential term? Tak ada kan? Jadi bila dah tak ada macam ni, you boleh selesaikan secara algebra. Okey. Jadi kalau you tengok di sini, nampak tak? Yang ini ys, ini ada ys, ini ada ys. Jadi yang ada ys ni kita semua boleh letakkan sebelah kanan. Dan yang tak ada ys ni, ini minus s y0, semua sebenarnya constant. Ini pun constant saja. Kita boleh letakkan sebelah kanan. Okey. Jadi kita akan buat seperti ini. Mana yang ada ys, mana yang ada the output ni kita letak sebelah kanan, dan yang tak ada kita letak sebelah sini. Okey. Dan selepas itu, mana yang kita boleh faktorkan, kita faktorkan. Ini semua sama kan? Ys ni semua sama kat sini. Jadi kita faktorkan seperti itu. Okey, yang ini y0 semua sama. Okey, jadi kita faktorkan seperti itu. Okey. Dan selepas itu kita perlu tinggalkan saja the ys. Yang selain daripada ys ni kalau boleh kita bawa ke sebelah kanan. Okey. Dan sebab kita nak bawa dia ke sebelah kanan, jadi yang ini kali bila kita bawa sebelah kanan dia akan jadi bahagi. Okey. Jadi at the end kita akan dapat equation seperti ini in term of ys. Okey, sebab ys adalah output yang kita kehendaki. Betul tak? Okey. Jadi ini adalah penyelesaian kita. Okey. Kita ada ys, the response is equal to ms m kali s plus b. Okey, and then the whole thing kalikan dengan y0 dibahagikan dengan m s square plus bs plus k. Okay. So this is the response equation basically yang kita kehendaki. Okay. Sebab once kita dapat equation ini nanti, kita boleh analyze the response. Kan? Barulah kita boleh analyze the response. Okay. Dan equation ini kita boleh tuliskan juga dalam bentuk ini. The PS is the function yang di atas ini. Okey. Dan yang di bawah ni mungkin kita boleh represent dengan QS. Okey. Nanti kita akan cerita lebih lanjut kenapa kita selalu consider satu di atas, satu di bawah ini. Boleh ikut lah tadi. Okey, di denominator pembawah tadi polynomial QS, when set equal to zero, it is called as characteristic equation. Yang pembawah tadi QS, dia ada namanya, dipanggil selalunya dengan characteristic equation. Okey, kalau saya sebut characteristic equation, you kena faham bahawa saya are referring to the equation yang dekat bawah tu. Okey, because the root of this equation determine the character of the time response. Later on saya akan tunjuk yang mana kenapa dia dipanggil sebagai characteristic equation. Sebab dia akan menunjukkan character of the behavior of the system nanti. The root of this characteristic equation are also called pole of the system. Okay? Dan kalau characteristic equation tu kita samakan dia dengan kosong, kita boleh dapatkan punca-puncanya. Okay? Dan bila kita dapatkan punca-puncanya, punca-puncanya akan dipanggil sebagai pole. Okay? Kutub. Nanti pun saya akan terangkan kemudian kenapa dia dipanggil poles. Dan seterusnya, the roots of the numerator polynomial PS are called the zero of the system. Okay? Yang di atas, equation yang di atas tu PS, kalau kita samakan dia dengan kosong, okay, kita juga boleh dapatkan punca-puncanya. Okay? Dan punca-punca ini dipanggil sebagai zero, sifar. Okay? Okay? Kalau kita lihat daripada kita punya equation tadi, PS adalah sama dengan MS plus B kali Y0. Okay? Kalau kita equate yang ni sama dengan 0, what happen? Okay? Maksudnya kita boleh letakkan sama ada Y0 equal to 0 ataupun MS plus B equal to 0. Okay? Jadi kita boleh dapatkan ni dan kita boleh dapatkan punca. Okay? Bila kita ada MS plus B equal to 0, okay? Kita boleh selesaikan untuk value S ni apa? Okay? Kita bawa ke sini B jadi minus B. Dan kemudian kita bawa M ke sebelah sini. Jadi kita akan dapati S equal to minus B over M. Okay? So because yang ini kita telah samakan yang atas ni dengan 0 tadi. Because of that kita dapat punca ni. Dan this is one of the punca. Okay, the roots. Dan root ini dipanggil sebagai zero. Okay, sebab dia berada dekat atas. Okay, one of the zero of the system is equal to minus B over M. Okay, the pole and zero are critical frequency. Okay, nanti kita akan sentuh juga yang mana bila kita bercakap dengan dalam S domain ni, dia berkaitan dengan frekuensi nanti. Okay, at the poles, the function YS become infinite, whereas at the zero, the function become zero. Okay, apa maksud ni? Okey, apabila apabila the function tu berada pada poles, okey, ingat ya, pole tadi yang daripada punca-punca yang berada di bawah tadi. Okey. The response akan jadi infinite. Kenapa the response jadi infinite? Sebab tadi bila kita nak dapatkan the pole tadi, kita nak dapatkan punca-punca, kita kena equate QS tu sama dengan kosong. Jadi sekarang you ada YS tu equal to PS dibagikan dengan QS. Dan QS tu sama dengan kosong. Jadi it's equal to PS dibagikan dengan kosong. That's why anything dibagikan dengan kosong akan jadi infinity. Okay? Jadi maksudnya sekarang ni, kalau you punya sistem berada dekat poles, okay, the response akan jadi infinity. Okay. Whereas, sekiranya apabila the system berada dekat zero, apabila dia berada dekat zero, okay, PS akan jadi kosong. Jadi kosong divided dengan QS basically akan jadi kosong. Maksudnya the response juga akan jadi kosong. Okay, that's why benda tu dipanggil sebagai pole dan zero. Okay, pole sebab dia akan menyebabkan the response berada dekat infinity, dan bila zero dia akan menyebabkan the response menjadi kosong. Okay, jadi itu beberapa definition tentang characteristic equation, pole dan juga zero. Okay, yang mana kita akan gunakan kelak. Okay, tapi yang penting tadi bagaimana untuk kita dapatkan penyelesaian menggunakan Laplace transform. Okay, saya janji tadi untuk 11.45 kita berhenti. Okeylah, kita berhenti sekarang ni. Okay. Tapi sebelum tu jangan keluar dulu, saya nak check attendant kejap.